Okie dokie. Well, morning, everybody. And back on after playing Gems of War for a few hours. Well, now I'm here to try out Amberland 2. It's a brand new game. I think it came out either yesterday or the day before, somewhere around there. So, after having played the first one for a while and kind of liked it, but it got to where the battles were just big slobber knocker, knockdown, drag out fights, and they just. The enemies got more. The enemy scaled up higher than my characters did. So, like I said, it got to where battles were like a major pain in the butt, so I didn't quit playing officially, but I'd have to set aside big chunks of time just to get somewhere on there. So, yeah. I'm hoping this game here, they kind of remedy the issue, but we'll see as the game progresses. So, and I'm probably just gonna be on for probably about a couple hours. I still got shit to do this morning, so yeah. And the in-game music, just like the previous game, it's kind of obnoxious and annoying. So I gotta go to the well with my playlist here, and we're gonna start off with Falgar, Mr. Rales de something. I think it's Spanish. Mysterios de Lerbeta. Oh. And I kind of messed up. Hold on. Well, if I'm playing two different... Oh. These are two different videos. So, I think we'll go ahead and I'll do a custom team. Everyone has the encumbrance, yeah, Hildwarf. Yeah, my warrior's gotta have encumbrance, because a good chunk of the armor in this game is super heavy. Frontline fighters are probably gonna have fairly high dexterity because I gotta be able to hit. Can't be missing in this game. Thank you. one should tell you how much encumbrance you have. So, last time I had hybrid classes, but from experience, they weren't that helpful. So, oh, they changed that. It used to be just, you know, like immune to confusion, but it seems now we're just getting resistance. Yeah. And you as well, Weird. And the previous game, you just had a straight up immunity to confusion, but now it looks like we have resistance. So. This is some of their some of the class abilities on here. You can only use once per rest, basically once per day. Fuck that shit. This is something else I often complain about, like, you know, from all the Dungeons and Dragons books I got, other RPGs as well. You know, some of these fucking classes, you know, like. Warrior, a powerful fighter with capable of performing devastating blows that can instantly one-shot your opponent. But you look at it, you look at their class ability, and you can only use the shit once per day. It's hardly even worth fucking advertising. And I need to look at something real quick. Okay, so it looks like it still fits my OBS. I just now noticed this. Yeah, I forgot to full screen the game from my end. But yeah, Bard's got the same shit. They are capable of healing and boosting other characters by performing songs. I had a Bard on the last game. You can only do it once per rest. So it's there, but, you know, something else, Bart. He's all about the music. Why am I only able to do his shit once per day? Once per rest. I'll kind of explain how resting works. It does work better in this game than it does some of the other RPGs out there. But still, you can't. The Bart's a fucking musician. I ought to be able to use it more than once, you know, once in a great while. Okay, let me turn it down. Thanks for telling me. Of course, I just now noticed I'm actually having to talk over the music. So what I'll go ahead and do is, the two slots are gonna be elves. And I gotta... So I'll have my, I had an archer and bard in my previous game. Didn't really think much of them. What I will do is, I'll have these two slots here, these sages. Oh, they got a chef in here. Sleep at that. And then we're gonna have the full-blown wizard and healer. And away we go. And that's something else this game has that the previous one didn't. Secret walls. Yeah. Looks like they don't have flat-out immunities in this game now, so... Yeah, all four. I'll take it.
Oh.
Okay, will do, Chief. Go with this shit. Yeah. So, right out of the gate, he's already fucking paralyzed. Just pull the lever and the security gate will open. Welcome to the old castle. I forget the name of the channel. Like, Best Indie Games, something like that. It's this, guy from Singapore. Hello, Indie Game Bud, and welcome once again to this week's edition of Indie Games. You know that guy? Yeah, he mentioned this game that it's out, so, gotta get on that. Yeah, same here. Yeah, that would be pretty damn bad for a game like this, yet it still crashes on my computer. Taking an arrow to the knee. Sucks to be you, bud. I said this in the video I did about this game. You know, it's nice to have these at the heal the party, but they need to heal the MP too. I mean, especially in higher levels where monsters can already fuck you up pretty bad. I kind of need the mana just as much as if not more than the health. So these are almost pointless if they don't heal your magic as well. Yeah, I'm guessing in the second version, they must have had a bigger budget to play with than the previous one, because, you don't see stuff like this in the previous game. You know, extra wall adornments and stuff. Extra, you know, pictures, portraits, etc. Usually all you saw was stuff like this. This guy's fucking hardcore. Papers must flow. It's the blood of the kingdom. If it stops thousands of tiny tasks will remain undone, and that will lead to the downfall of the kingdom. But on the OCD side. It's like bureaucratic to the end. I see more of these too. NPC, or free, I guess, for lack of a better word, freestanding NPCs. In the previous game, you only saw them whenever you entered those doors. That's a princess who don't want a princess anymore.
Sure.
This kingdom was about as lawful as it gets. But yeah, like I said, in the last game, you didn't see freestanding NPCs like this. The only places where you saw them were in the doors. So, like I said, I'm thinking this game must have gotten a bigger budget. That's what happens when your kingdom hasn't been infiltrated in many, many years. You just start talking about secret shit out in the open. Seems like this kingdom could use a good fucking up. You know, you start assassinating kings in here and stuff like that, and they'll start keeping a tight lip about stuff. Yeah, it's also pretty damn bad when it's like, the maids know more about, now that I think about it, this is actually true in real life. More often than not, the inmates can run the asylum. I'm seeing that here too. It's like the frickin' maids know more about running the kingdom than the frickin' kings do. Again, I'm gonna switch to another album. It is. I guess this will work. A royal food tester. Of course. Sounds like the kind of like the prison inmates around here that wear the orange jumpsuits that pick up trash on the side of the road. It's just there to give them work. Sounds like this here. I mean, unless, you know, now if a kingdom was at war with another kingdom, food testers are actually super valuable because you never know, somebody might have snuck in and poisoned your food. I know in ancient times, they would actually feed the food to their dog. And if the dog rolled over dead, whoop, throwing that batch away. Oh, and for those that don't know, I don't read stuff out loud. It's just very distracting. Plus, I've actually abandoned streamers that do this. They'll start reading text out loud. It's like, man, shut up, you know, end up bailing. So. And if you've got a strong stomach, look up Dubai Porta Potty. This kind of reminds me of that. I've said this before too. When you have the infinite punch cheat, you tend to do stupid shit. Yeah. courtyard. I had to fight these guys in the previous game. Alright, so back to the Chancellor. Chamberlain. I think that's it. We're talking to the princess again. Actually, I don't need to rest. Oh, damn. okay, magic upon is nice, but does it heal your magic as well? Oh, excuse me. Long Island.
If you are listening this, congratulations. You won an invitation for coming to Skull Beach and participate on the Transylvanian Grand Prix. We also want you guys for playing on the ending of the festival.
Hardly hear it. Sure, not a whole lot of fighting. Thank you. that's right, I can't advance.
Welcome to the Skull Beach. We're so glad you come in time for the festival. This is great. Prepare your boards. It's about to start.
Jeez. I'm at... Yeah, this game's definitely different from the previous one. I'm spending more time exploring than I am actually fighting. Lead. Gee, you think? Kind of like a book of grudges, but for librarians. Dewey! well, shit, you guys are some serious bookworms. Oh damn, I got a bunch of them. She's running out of mana. Missing. Can't be missing. Oh,
you all for coming to the festival, all the competitors and all the people that came to watch all you guys rock. Now it's time to call them, the legendary band that came from the Dukes of the Black Seas, the Sir Gnomes.
Oh!
Well, I got off to a shitty start. Supposed to be here yet. Shit. Thank you. Yeah, that's something else too. There should be a, if there's a secret wall or door, there should be something a little bit off on it. And not have it look exactly like all the other walls. And whoa, we're down to 10% charge on my tablet. I might end up having to suddenly call it off. Holy shit, I was not thinking about that. So let me check my cell phone real quick. I gotta get this tablet on the charger. Okay. Yeah, 15% remaining, so. This one here is only at about 50% charge, so. Actually, you know what? Since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I need to use the bathroom and it's all fill this back up. I'll be back. Thank you. Yes, indeed.
What a pity, sighed a tired toad in a shabby green robe. He was staring at the once beautiful mushroom house, masterfully carved by himself a long time ago. But now it was just an old, crooked building with pale moss and thick spider web covering every curve and window. The entrance with a round oaken door almost collapsed, and a part of the cap roof fell off. Last pair of winters were obviously too harsh, even for such a carefully planned architecture. It was one of the first projects that he mastered all by himself after finishing the carving school of the Great Bog. He was then noticed, and after 5 years of honest hard work, he was invited to plan a project of the Royal Castle, together with a few more famous carvers from the far swamps. It is hard to describe what a huge honor it was for him, and as he saw his name, Brog the Builder, woven with a golden thread amongst others on the huge royal carpet decorating the main castle hall, he stood there dazed with a clear thought. This is it. This is the biggest creation of my life. However, it was surprisingly painful to see that insignificant old creation in front of him slowly vanishing. It was an ordinary house for a simple toad family, but it was where everything started. Well, muttered Brog the Builder to himself. waking up from his own thoughts. This family needs a new home anyway, and I will do my best to create the most beautiful thing in a simple way I've ever made before.
Snakes, that's not good. Fuck with the swamp just yet. Got to get the coordinates. So, 6440. Whoops. He's still fucking missing. God, you guys can't even hit the broadside of the barn.
Quite rustling in the thick swamp bushes got attention for the little toad, playing with his friend in the late summer evening.
Hush, what was that? I didn't hear anything, but it could be fish or just a breeze. No, no, replied the first toad, a little worried. There is surely something bigger than a fish, and it moves above the water.
In that moment, a sharp boat's edge appeared out of the plant's thickness. An old, frowning toad was sitting on that boat, made of a dried, oiled water lily, with two big sacks on each side of it. Focused on his own thoughts, he did not smile. Yet the children could say that he was a friendly creature.
Good evening, little folks, said the boat toad, and coughed. I hope I did not disturb your peaceful game. I am just passing by to see if the south corner of the swamp already has something to offer. What is it the swamp can offer you?
Asked one of the little toads with undisguised interest.
The finest berries in all the kingdom, of course. Now, have a good evening, little ones. I've got no time to waste.
With these words, he made two strong pushes with his beautiful, lightweight paddle and disappeared behind the low willow branches.
Who was that?
Asked the youngest toad.
That was old Bog, the berry belly,
said the other one proudly.
My granny told me stories about him and his craft. He doesn't like company, but as far as I know, every cure potion we've got for winter is made out of these rare berries he finds. Oh, it is getting late. Let's get back home before everyone starts to worry about us. I want to be a boat toad too when I grow up,
cried the youngest toad, inspired, catching up with his friend up the hill.
Whoops. Whoops. Yeah. We better save first. It's a fucking fat troll, you shouldn't be missing. God, you guys suck. Yeah, I had to do this a lot on the previous game. Didn't help. Three stinking hit points. And then once I get to a town, I'll probably end up calling it a sesh. Oh, I forgot. This place has a pawn shop. Not right now.
It was a dark winter night. And the wind was howling like a thousand beasts. For 3 days, a hunter had been chasing a peculiar creature, a fairy bug of the great bog. It was such a rare thing to come across this bug that its shadowed nature started to grow over with dozens of strange stories and myths. Okay. Some believed that it was a witch trapped in a body of an insect.
Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it from everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. Just beginning to nod off, so yeah, and plus I have a bunch of stuff I gotta get taken care of this morning. I got two stream videos I now have to get prepped up and then exported to YouTube. Blog posts as well. I've got a crap ton of stuff I gotta get put down on that too, so I'm gonna have one busy morning and then yeah, my cell phone's at 50%, but yeah, like I said, I got a lot of stuff I gotta get taken care of this morning, so, yeah, anyway, mine's kind of wanting to giddy up go, so, but anyway, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody, I appreciate that, and, I'm thinking maybe, streaming this game, again, I would probably say, I'd probably say Wednesday morning, cause in Gems of War there's not gonna be a whole lot going on that day, you know, no long faction assault or anything like that, anything that would run the session to like a couple hours, that kind of thing. So chances are on Wednesday, just do the daily basic stuff in Gems of War, get that taken care of, and then switch on over to this game. So that's what's currently on the agenda right now. Again, mine's wandered off, so just thanks again for dropping by, everybody. I appreciate that, and I'll see you all next time.